And welcome back to the Conscious Consultant Hour, Awakening Humanity. We've been speaking this hour with Dr. Bertrand Babinet, author of the book, Empowering the Heart, Restoring the Peace, Healing the Hurt, and Sharing Your Gifts. Where can people find the book? Is it in Amazon and all the usual places?
Well, right now it's a little tricky because we worked with Balboa Press.
Okay.
And my recommendation is never publish a book with Balboa Press.
Did not have a good experience.
No, horrible experience. We just pulled it out because it's a money-making machine where they exploit people who are doing their first book to get as much money for as little service as possible. So we finally canceled it. So it's available on my website at the stage. At this stage, this is the best way to go there.
Okay, and what's your website?
It's babinetics.com.
Babinetics, which is B-A-B-I-N-E-T-I-C-T-S.
No, so it's Babinetic, B-A-B-I-N-E-T-I-C-S.
Right,
Babinetics.com.
Okay, wonderful.
And it has the book is there, all my work is there, all the description of the work I do on the body, all the work I do psychologically, the workshops I give, on my website.
So the majority of your work is sort of about taking people who have trauma and stuff and bring them up to what we say is functional or zero, but really taking people who are functional or at zero and taking them up to sort of the positive direction. But are there techniques or are there things in your book that can help people who have experienced trauma and other very difficult things and help them to become more than just functional?
Well, I think the first thing is really to teach them how to access the heart.
Okay.
Because when they start reclaiming the spiritual alignment, they are no longer a victim.
Right.
And so they are going to cooperate or with whatever is going on as an expansion process rather than a contraction process.
Right. Now, trauma is often it's stored in the body. It's actually stored in the nervous system. And so it can be scary for somebody to try and access their heart when they've experienced that. How do you kind of gently guide them there?
Well, the symbol. The symbol, you see, because the symbol is pretty neutral. The word symbol in Latin means to reconnect.
Oh, really?
Symbole. Symbole means to reconnect. The opposite of symbol is devil. The devil is what disconnect. Deeper. So symbole is what reconnects us, and devil is what pulls us apart. Okay, we have a lot of devils in society right now pulling us apart.
Yeah.
Okay, but so we need more symbol. And so a symbol of peace is something that brings you back in alignment with your peace and with your loving.
Right.
But I'm a great believer that when there is peace, there is love.
Right.
It's automatic. And when there is love, there is, you know, higher consciousness. And when there is higher consciousness, there is no need.
Mm.
You know, there is fulfillment. So the big key is always to come back to that doorway and work with that doorway as an opening into the spiritual, and then realize that in our soul, all the qualities we need for our life are already programmed.
Right.
Humor, playfulness, aliveness, joy, gentleness, caring, flexibility, willingness to learn, openness to spirit. It's all there.
Right.
You know, we don't have to make it up. There is... We are already all we need to be.
Right.
There is nothing to fix.
Right. We are not broken. We do not need to be fixed.
We don't need to be fixed. See, all we need is to learn how to access
it,
to the resources which have always been there, but that we didn't see because our focus was outward rather than inwards.
Yeah.
You know, we have no practice to reconnect and to reclaim those gifts which were already there.
Right.
So we always looked out there saying, if only I had this, I would be happy.
Right,
if only I had a better job, I would be happy. If only my body didn't hurt, I would be happy.
Right.
The idea is be happy.
Happy, and then you'll have the other things, right?
Choose happy, you know, it's already there. So
one of my teachers likes to say that, you know, sort of psychological issues are really maladies of the soul. And it sounds like you take sort of a more energetic/spiritual approach to things, And it's like, what is going on within this person's spirit or soul that's causing this thing to manifest in the way it is in their life?
I would put it exactly the opposite way.
Oh, okay.
I would say there is no malady of the soul.
Ah.
It's a contradiction in terms.
Okay.
The soul is whole and complete.
It's
an aspect
perfect.
Of the divine. So it's our separation from the soul that create the malady, and our seeking outward for what is already within. That's the malady. There is no malady in the soul.
So it's the illusion of separateness.
You got
it. It's the illusion that we are separate from each other. We are separate from our environment. We are separate from the rock, you know, in the
you
street.
You got it. We're a different field, dance, contractor. No, we're not.
Yeah.
We're a joyful spirit having a human experience.
Absolutely.
And sometimes it's a little challenging. Yeah. A little iffy. And so my big advice to all the people who are listening, there are two keys in life that will keep you in good standing.
Okay.
Humor.
Okay.
And gentleness.
Yes.
Be gentle with yourself.
Absolutely.
People
I'm with you.
Are their worst enemy. They are driving themselves crazy.
Yes.
They're creating all those stories that means absolutely nothing,
mm-hmm.
which are just stories.
Right. It's all made up.
Yeah. If we could let go of the stories and go back to our heart, we would have a fantastic time, individually and collectively.
Yeah.
You know, it's a great, look at the beauty in the world, you know.
Yes.
I mean, I know that compared to the soul, it's nothing, although I don't have that experience.
Mm.
But to me, you go to nature, you listen to music,
right.
you look at babies, you look at kids. I've been spending 2 days with my grandchildren. You know, I mean, there's nothing better than that.
Yeah.
It's amazing. You know? I have 5 of them. I could spend
5 time. Grandkids. Wow.
And my wife has 4. So together we have 9.
Oh, my God.
Because I did get remarried after my wife passed away.
Oh, okay. Okay. So you seem to me be the kind of gentleman that doesn't necessarily sit still for that long. what comes next for Dr. Babinet?
Okay, so we are relaunching our training. We have a training which is called Empowering the Heart and Transformation. So we are relaunching that because I stopped doing a lot of training while my wife was sick.
Oh, okay.
You know, so now we're back into relaunching a lot more of the psycho-spiritual work.
Mm-hmm.
And so we have a 5-module training, you know.
Oh.
The first one is very much energetics.
Mm-hmm.
On learning how to clear the body and the psyche
mm-hmm.
using very simple tool of the heart.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have a more advanced workshop, which have a lot more to do with the material of the book and clearing, you know, stuff in the genetic, in the karma, things like that.
Yeah, yeah,
how do we move forward, basically?
Right. And are those trainings, are they only in person or are they available online?
So far, they're just on person
okay.
because I really believe that if you do things just online, people get the concept, they never get the experience.
Gotcha. And so, given we're in New York City, are you going to do any of these trainings here in New York?
You know, my point of view about the training is very simple. You invite me and I'll be here.
Yeah. Wonderful.
I'm 77 years old. You know, I don't push.
Gotcha.
I don't push. People invite me. They make things happen. And I'm delighted to come forward.
Wonderful. Wonderful.
So I, you know.
Well, thank you so much, Dr. Babinet, for coming on the show today. I really appreciate all that you're doing, all that you've done, the book. Once again, if people want to get in touch with you, your website is babinetics.com, babinetics.com.
This is correct. This is wonderful. Definitely the best way. They can get my number. They can get, you know, all information from there.
Right. Okay, wonderful. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
You have a wonderful rest of your day, and I look forward to Maybe seeing that training manifest here in New York sometime. Hey,
I'm open.
All right, great, okay. Great.
Thank you, Simon. It was very nice having me.
You're welcome. I really appreciate it. You're welcome. And so I just want to remind everybody to stay tuned, because coming up next is Kai Cole and her show, Our Daily Magic, talking about sustainable sisterhood today, followed by a special edition of the Conscious Consultant Hour at 2 p.m. With my guest, Dr. Hal... Dr. Hal Blattman, and we're actually going to be talking all about sort of stem cell. We're going to go a little bit more on the medical side of stuff. A very interesting gentleman, and it'll be another fascinating show. So make sure you stay tuned till all the way till 3 p.m. today, so you get all these great shows. And just to let you know, we are shifting the schedule a little bit, and Kai Cole's show will be shifting to Tuesday evenings after this week. So thank you all for listening. I'll talk to you in an hour. Stay tuned. Don't go anywhere. Our Daily Magic coming up next.